out of everything that we do here, batteries are always the limitation. With the flight times being shorter, we need to be able to come down and really efficiently and safely swap out the batteries with very little infrastructure or fasteners.
A huge amount of work has gone into that battery. We've gone through a few stages of development, a lot of design work, a lot of CAD work, and then a lot of building and testing, and getting to the point of developing better methods of testing, better methods of building, so that we know that that battery is not going to be the failure point in the system.
Contact.
Contact.
Open circuit. Contact.
Contact. Open circuit. Yeah, I love the aesthetic. I've got to say, like, I put a lot of effort into the design of the battery, and aesthetic was not my design goal, but I think anybody who looks at the battery can see that aesthetic was a consideration. Sport has a huge influence on our design. Electric vehicles on the road have to be charged, so the vehicle itself has to be charged because the battery is integrated into that system. Whereas we want to drive really high power, really quickly, we're going to run out of battery and deplete that battery. We don't want to have people jumping out of vehicles to race multiple vehicles. We want to be able to switch those batteries out. So that's a huge proponent of what we've done with this design. These batteries slide in on the rails and lock in on those electrical connections. And then we also have additional mechanical connections as a safety feature, but the idea eventually is to get to the point where I push that battery into the vehicle, that's ready to go.
With current battery technology, we are limited in terms of how much, if you like, energy per kilogram we can put in the vehicle. Come with other electric vehicles, the energy density is a limiting factor for the performance of the vehicle. We want to be able to support racing, and to do that we need to change the battery in order to achieve that race performance and also achieve the time in the air. This then can become a strategic option, for, if you like, a strategic advantage for the teams, how they manage the depletion of the batteries and when they choose to change batteries. This is also affected, if you like, by the circuit, and that will, different circuits will have different energy requirements. Teams may find that it's advantageous for certain tracks to employ full performance and schedule the maximum, if you like, the maximum number of batteries for that race. Other teams may decide that it's better to manage the power use and actually look for a longer period between battery changes. These certainly are possibilities, and when we start flying, we can then test out some of these strategies and see how the vehicles respond to these kind of variables.